Bonjour Paris, we have made it to Paris finally. And we are starving and we need
so hungry.
To we put on some comfy clothes. And this is probably the intro to the vlog. Sorry, very, very abrupt intro. I was robbed. Yeah, story time later, but I was robbed at the airport in Nice, coming back from the south of France to Paris. So anyway, we finally got here and we just need to like get some food, chill out for a little bit. We had to cancel our lunch resi because it was outside on a terrace, but it's raining. So we're just gonna do something chill for lunch and get like a cute cafe vibe. So yeah. Danielle's first time at Cafe de Flore, had to take her here to try the iconic hot chocolate and strawberries. It's literally delicious, and we needed this after like a rainy shopping day. Very chill vibe. This is from Addicted, and I'm wearing a little clip in my hair. I was like between wearing a bow or a clip, but I feel like with the bows here, it's like too much to wear a bow in the back of my hair too. But we're gonna go to a cool cafe that is kind of new, I've never been. It looks so cute online, and we're gonna do that. Go to a museum later. Just walk around, see things. It's raining a little bit, so I'm gonna bring an umbrella. But yeah, I'm sad about the rain. But I like it at the same time. Like, I love rain personally. It's just annoying because I want to sit like outside and take photos outside. And then it's hard because I have to like hold an umbrella or something. But anyway, shades on. I'm gonna wear a jacket, it is a little chilly. But yeah. Ready for the day in Paris. got served our first course. I got a glass of the white wine. I know it's like weird with steak to have white wine, but I don't really care. It sounded better to me. And then salad. Bonsoir. Wait, you actually said that good. That was good for you, yeah. Got coffee at this coffee shop that I've been dying to go to called Noor, and I'm wearing a really obnoxious workout outfit.
So
I'm sorry, but what? Like, who is so this?
Cute.
Who?
Like what?
I literally had a mental breakdown in the cafe. I feel like I have too many mental breakdowns in Paris sometimes. Like, way too many. It's really bad. I don't know what it is about this city, but I feel a little bit better.
Also love it at the same time.
I love it so much. I want to love it. I try so hard to love it. This is the first time I've seen blue sky since we were in the south of France. Like, that's how depressing it's been. I had reservations outside on the terrace for like the past 2 days. But hopefully today we'll be able to sit outside and enjoy our reservations, enjoy the beautiful summer vibes, because we're trying to have a European hot girl summer. But it's been like
Hello.
So rainy and cold.
But
getting robbed did not help either, but
it sounds promising. Like, look at the sky. She is out, it's sunny.
And yesterday was so cold and rainy, and like I was trying to still make it a good day, but it was not. No, it was like
we
tried
trekking through the rain.
Yeah,
to thrift stores.
Yeah, yeah.
Wearing like tiny little mini dresses.
No, we were wearing
like
mini dresses.
Barely any like cover up.
Exactly. Like, we needed to be. It needed to be a sunny day, or at least not raining.
Yeah.
And we were trying to like take photos outside the cafe yesterday, and it was raining, and they just like were not coming out that well.
Everything was
just going wrong. I don't know. It was
the steak. If you saw the steak, though.
Oh yeah, we had a really good dinner. We had a really good steak and fried dinner.
Yeah.
But yeah. Comment down below if you think I should move back to Paris, or if you think that I'm cursed when I'm in Paris.
Or she should move to LA.
Yeah.
She should move to LA.
Danielle just moved to LA from New York, and I'm also debating moving to LA from New York, but
you can do both. You can go back and forth.
I'm like, what is going on with the sun, yay, sun. Sorry, I'm just like vlogging this whole experience. I'm so happy. The sun is out.
This is so nice.
Yay!
Careful, Gail.
Finally, the deck has gotten nice enough, and like the sun has come out again. Take pictures, and I'm wearing this dress. I was gonna wear it to lunch at Giraffe, but we could not do that. But yeah, look, the sun is here, and I think we are gonna walk around a little bit. We have dinner later at like 9, but yeah, gonna walk around. It's so nice out now. Cute outfit. I love the bow.
Sorry.
Look at the sun, guys.
You guys.
It is insane. That's so pretty. Oh my god. Already so for dinner. Pretty. It's so bright out. It's literally like 9 p.m. And
guys,
look at the sun.
I was not expecting this.
It's beautiful outside, though. I was drinking my espresso out here, making some TikToks, and like, stunning. Honestly, I should have made all the dinners like at 10 p.m. because I didn't even realize that it was gonna be dark this late. In the south of France, it got dark a little bit earlier, I think. So, yeah. But we're going to a really fun dinner tonight. I'm very excited. My outfit is from Princess Polly, and then these shoes are thrifted. But, yeah. To bring my vlogging camera to Pilates this morning, but we did Pilates, or not Pilates, I keep saying Pilates, it's yoga, we did yoga. And I wore this really cute set with this white thing I got from Amazon, and I love it, it's so cute. I love how it like covers the shoulders. But yeah, and then I just went to the embassy to get my new passport, and I have to go pick it up at I have to go pick up the passport at 2, which is annoying because it kind of cuts into the day. But I'm so glad to get a passport because we're leaving to Spain tomorrow. Today is like our last full day, which I'm sad about because I feel like we did not get to do all the stuff I wanted to do in Paris. It was just a wild ride. While I was at the embassy, Danielle picked me up my favorite croissant. I'm so excited.
She is not getting sold out.
Almond chocolate. Sorry for the strange angle, but I wanted to show you guys. I made a shot of espresso. It's huge. Literally, it's up to like here on the cup. You can't see or else I'll spill the espresso from this angle, but I'm gonna use my brain dust. This stuff is amazing. But yeah, I'm just gonna take a little bit of this and mix it. All the spoons were dirty. Gonna mix it into my espresso because it really helps me to focus and just my brain to function correctly. It has lion's mane in it, so really good. Cheers. So good. I'm gonna drink this and have my pastry. I'm gonna get ready for lunch. Guys, I am ready. ready for lunch. I am so obsessed with this dress. This dress is from Fait Parfouch. Sorry, my voice is like dying right now. So I sound a little weird saying the name of the brand, but I'm obsessed with it. I had to get it tailored because they only had a size small available and I needed extra small. So had to get it tailored, but it fits perfectly. I feel like you can wear the strap down like this, or you can wear the straps up more like this. So I'm probably just gonna switch between both throughout the day like that. But yeah, we're going to lunch at Coco, which is one of my favorite restaurants in Paris. I had my birthday, my 21st birthday dinner at Coco, so I'm very excited. I don't know if we'll be able to sit outside, but the inside is very, very cute. So yeah, I have to go to the embassy to pick up my passports. So we're late to lunch because of that. So yeah, but still looking cute nonetheless. Doing some last minute shopping and
Ralph's coffee.
We're getting Ralph's coffee.
We're actually getting matchas because we've had so much coffee today.
Yeah, I'm probably gonna get a matcha. My voice, I need something to drink clearly because I can barely speak right now. We went to Celine and I ended up getting some new Celine sunglasses because, yeah, I've had mine for like 3 years now, 2 or 3 years, and it was just time for a new pair of kind of like everyday classic sunglasses. And I've been wearing these ones from And Other Stories and they're amazing. I love them so much, but it would be nice to like have a good designer classic pair that are similar, and I found that today at Celine. So I will show you. I guess I should tell you guys the whole story about getting robbed, even though my voice sounds horrible. As I unbox this, I can tell you. So we are at the Nice airport and we missed our first flight because we were like late for the check-in time. So we had to go wait for like hours. So we're like, let's go to the Joe and the Juice. Well, the Joe and the Juice was past the check-in for security and they wouldn't let us check in for our flight early because we were there so early. We were there at like 3 o'clock and our flight was at 9. So then there's a terminal, another terminal that had a Joe and the Juice. So we're like, let's take this tram and go to the other terminal instead of this Joe and the Juice. So we're sitting at the Joe and the Juice and this like spiritual lady starts to talk to me and she's like, people just like to come and take your things from you. You have weird energy. You need to clear your energy. And we're just sitting at Joe and the Juice. And it was weird because this woman who was a French woman, only spoke French, and she was trying to like take something from me, like my napkin. I didn't know what she wanted, so I was like, do you want my sandwich? What do you want? Like, my French is not that good. I don't know the word for napkin in French. And she was just like grabbing. So I was like, here, take the sandwich, whatever. And then she just takes my napkin and walks away. And that's when the woman who was sitting over there was like, you need to clear energy, whatever. And I'm like, I believed in like spirituality. I believe in signs from the universe, all that stuff. But this made me rethink all that, or this is just like a weird coincidence. I don't know. It was crazy because after that,
we went to the tram after we waited for hours. The lady, the woman was still there the whole time watching me, like literally just watching us basically, which I should have known that it was suspicious that people around me, like around us where we were sitting, were not getting up to go to their flight. But obviously people are lounging waiting for their flight, so it's not like that suspicious to me, but I guess I should be more careful. So, because we were there for like hours, so it was kind of weird that she never, like, sorry, I forgot I was even holding these to unbox, but it was weird that she never left to go to her own flight. So I don't know. Yeah, we leave the terminal and we get on the tram. As we're getting on the tram, I have my suitcase like this to roll and my bag sitting on top of the suitcase, because I roll it on, like, the suitcase rolls with the bag on top, my Pauline bag. Which, Pauline, I love you and I love your bags, but they need to have a zip if people are going to be traveling with them. If you're going to advertise them as a travel bag, I was robbed because it does not zip. And if it was zipped, I would have not been robbed. It doesn't zip. So I was pulling my bag onto the tram and I get ambushed by three girls. And they pretend that they're pushing my stuff onto the tram, and I was just trying to get it away from that. I don't like people touching my stuff, and I noticed they were being touchy, but I didn't see them take anything out of the bag, but they were touching the bag too much, and I was just trying to pull it as fast as I could onto the tram, and before I could even know, I had been robbed. And I'm looking down through the bag because I'm like, they were really touchy with my stuff. I didn't see them take anything. I'm looking, my passport. Where's my passport? I didn't notice anything. I noticed my camera was there, my laptop was there. Everything was there. My Louis Vuitton makeup bag was there. My wallet was there, but no passport. So I'm like, oh my God, my passport is gone. And I like yell and everyone's staring at me on the train. And then the train conductor comes in and he's like, pickpocket, you've been robbed. Chase after them. I'm like, what do I do? They took my passport. He's like, chase after them. You have to run. I'm like, so I get off the train with my baggage. They're nowhere to be found. Danielle runs to find the police. I call my dad. I'm like, I was robbed. Yeah. So, long story short, we missed our next flight to Paris that evening at 9 o'clock. We had to sleep in Nice at an airport hotel. And then the next day, we get on our flight. Whatever. Anyway. Yeah, so these were the sunglasses that I bought. I'm very obsessed with them. They're a little biggish, like, on my eyes. I don't know. I feel like they are a little big on my face. But I just wanted to buy something. For the longest time, I could not make up my mind if I should get Celine sunglasses, Miu Miu sunglasses. And when we spend so much time going to these different stores trying to decide. Well, I really like these and I think these are going to be perfect. And they're going to be classic. Actually, in the morning, we're going to try the cookie croissant. The viral cookie croissant that we tried to try in New York, but we could not get it. They were all sold out. So now we're going to try the real one in Paris. And I also need to run to another stores in the morning. And I'm going to get some earrings and other accessories because I don't have any jewelry now because I was robbed and they took my jewelry. Oh, I forgot to mention. So I realized that they took my jewelry when I was looking in the bag and I was like, my jewelry box is gone too. And that was the most upsetting. Like the passport, obviously I was scared because I'm like, we're going to Spain. We're about to go on a plane to another part of France. Like, are they gonna let me on? It was fine. And I ended up getting an emergency passport today, but I'm very sad because my collection of jewelry is gone. I was wearing my Cartier watch and my Cartier rings, thankfully, but I did lose like a Paul bracelet that was like 2,000 euro or more. And I lost my Chrome Hearts ring and just other things that I've gotten from like flea markets and just all my collection. Basically, I had like all my jewelry with me because I love wearing jewelry in the summer and this is like a summer trip. So it's really sad. At least I'm not hurt, and it could have been so much worse. Like, it could have been my whole bag or something, or just, yeah, there's just so much worse that could have happened.
Goodbye, Paris.